Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about DNA structure. What is DNA? DNA, which stands for deoxyribonucleic acid, is made up of basic unit called nucleotides. It is double-stranded and have double helix structure. It contains many genes. DNA carries genetic code, which is used to synthesize specific polypeptides. Let's zoom into the structure of the DNA. As you can see in this picture, in general DNA is made up of many nucleotides that has a phosphate group, sugar, and nitrogenous base. The sugar phosphate backbone of DNA, which is the red box, refers to the phosphate and sugar, which is deoxyribose, as this is DNA. The nucleotides are joined together by phosphodiester bonds. As mentioned earlier, DNA is double-stranded, and this is simply because it is made up of two strands of polynucleotides arranged in an antiparallel manner. The antiparallel arrangement gives rise to the double helix structure. In addition to the definition of DNA, we also have to know what is a chromosome and what is a gene. A chromosome is made up of DNA molecules wound around histone proteins and contains many genes. A gene is a sequence of nucleotides as part of a DNA molecule and controls the production of one polypeptide. Now, let's zoom into the nucleotide itself. The nucleotide is a basic unit of DNA. It is made up of three components. The phosphate group, represented by a circle and P in the diagram. The deoxyribose sugar, represented by the purple pentagon in the diagram. And the nitrogenous base, represented by the blue pentagon in the diagram. For DNA, there are four nitrogenous base, which are adenine, thymine, cytosine, and guanine. Do note that in RNA, which stands for ribonucleic acid, such as mRNA, they are made of adenine, uracil, cytosine, and guanine instead. Uracil is the equivalent of thymine. So how do the nucleotide bases pair up? They follow the rule of complementary base pairings. The rule is as follows: adenine is complementary to thymine and vice versa. And cytosine is complementary to guanine and vice versa. In simple terms, A and T will always pair up, C and G will always pair up. Therefore, the ratio of A to T and C to G in an organism is always 1 to 1. Earlier we mentioned nucleotides, DNA, genes, and chromosomes, but how are they all related? We know that nucleotides are the basic units of DNA, thus many nucleotides make up the polynucleotide. These polynucleotide run antiparallel to one another to form the double-stranded DNA. The DNA molecule then winds around histone proteins to form chromosome molecules. We also do know that a gene is a segment of DNA, thus a gene is made up of a few nucleotides as well. Since gene is a segment of DNA, many genes together make up DNA as well. That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.